गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर देशमुख अमोल जगन्नाथ, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, कॉलेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर, नवसारी एग्रीकल्चर यूनिवर्सिटी, वघई, गुजरात. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेक अ लेक्चर इन द कोर्स इंट्रोडक्टरी प्लांट नेमेटोलॉजी ऑफ सेकंड सेमिस्टर BSc ऑनर्स एग्रीकल्चर. द टॉपिक ऑफ द कोर्सेस रिप्रोडक्टिव एंड नर्वस सिस्टम ऑफ प्लांट पैथोजेनिक नेमेटोड्स. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विथ रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम ऑफ मेल नेमेटोड. सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी ऑब्जर्व हेयर दिस फिगर. इट कंटेन्स टेस्टिस, सेकंड वास डिफरेंस, थर्ड वन इज इजेकुलेटरी डक्ट, फोर्थ वन इज क्लोइका, फिफ्थ वन इज स्पिक्यूल एंड कॉपुलेटरी बोर्सा. सम ऑफ द पार्ट्स वेयर नॉट डिस्क्राइब्ड हेयर. सो हेयर इट इज अ सैक लाइक स्ट्रक्चर विच इज कॉल्ड एज सेमिनल वेसिकल. सो लेट अस डिस्कस वन बाय वन. फर्स्ट टेस्टिस. Testis is nothing but a sac-like structure which helps in the production of sperms. If the number of testis is 1, then it is called as monarchic condition, or if they are present in 2 numbers, then it is called as diarchic condition. So the testis functions in producing spermatozoa, which gives rise to sperm. So these are the sperms. Then seminal vesicle, it is a sac like structure which stores the sperms until the mating of male and female nematode occurs. Then third part is vas deferens. So it is a passage to carry sperms away from the testis toward the penis. Then ejaculatory duct. So the duct which is formed by the union of vas deferens and seminal vesicle is called as ejaculatory duct, which is a pair duct and act as a passage to pass semen or fluid which contains sperms. So spicule, so it is needle like structure which serves to open the vulva of the female and facilitate the transmission of sperms into the female vulva. It present singly or in 2 numbers and it is made up of hardened cuticle, and at the tip of this spicule there are sensory structure which is called as dendrites. So at the base of spicule there is also a structure present, it is called as gubernaculum. It is also cuticularized structure and which supports the movement of the spicule. Then there is also presence of bursa, which is filamentous cuticular expansion or hair like structures of body wall of the nematode, which is present below the cloaca, which is useful to hold the female while copulation. So here is cloaca. So cloaca is nothing but a common opening for reproductive as well as digestive system of nematode. So this is all about male reproductive system. So dear students, in exam anyone ask to draw out a figure and explain the different part of male reproductive system. So you can draw out this figure or another one, and you have to label these parts and explain each and every part in detail. So this is testis, vas deferens, this is seminal vesicle, and this is spicule through which these sperms were inserted into the female vulva while copulation. So there are two types of male reproductive system. One is monoarchic and second one is diarchic. In case of monoarchic, there is presence of single testis. If you see here in C diagram, it is having single testis. Whereas in case of A and B, there is diarchic condition. It is testes are two in number, and then it is followed by or preceded by seminal vesicle, which is preceded by vas deferens. So anyone may ask the difference between monoarchic and diarchic. So you can write easily. You can also give the example. So dear friends, we will now see the female reproductive system. So here in the figure, we can see first part is ovary, which produces egg or ovum. Then oviduct, which carries the egg. Third part is uterus here, which attaches the eggs or which is useful for the development of eggs or eggs maturation. Then this uterus and vulva gives rise to form a vagina, and a slit like opening is present. It is called as vulva. So this female is having two ovary, one is anterior and second is posterior. So according to the number of ovary and their position, the ovary of female reproductive system are classified into different groups. We will see later. So more thing I have to pinpoint here, that in between this oviduct and uterus, there is one part which is not available in this figure, but it is a spermatheca. So which is act as a reservoir. It is actually a sac like structure in which the sperms of male are present. They are stored for a long time, and whenever the egg of this ovary are passes through the spermatheca, they get fertilized. So once again, we can describe, or we can see all the organs. So ovary is nothing but the site for the production of oogonia or ovum or eggs and their growth. Oviduct, it is a narrow passage to transport oogonia. Spermatheca, to store sperms, and oogonia get fertilized when passed through it. Uterus, so it is womb or space where the attachment of egg takes place, or the growth and nourishment and maturation of egg takes place, and which gives rise to birth to juveniles. Then vagina, it is useful for expulsion of egg or juveniles. Vulva, it is slit like opening on the ventral side, and it is help in laying egg or egg one after copulation or during copulation. So this is all about the female reproductive system. So anyone can ask in your exam to draw out a well developed figure of female reproductive system of nematode. You can draw out and write down the name of different parts and explain accordingly. So there are different types of nematode ovary according to number and according to their site where they present, either anterior or posterior. They are classified into different types. So monodelphic female nematode with single ovary are called as monodelphic. Female nematode with having two ovary, then these are called as didelphic. Prodelphic female nematode with single ovary, which is presented or directed towards anterior position to the vulva, then such type of ovary is called as prodelphic ovary. Then opisthodelphic female nematode with single ovary present or directed towards posterior position to vulva, then it is called as opisthodelphic. Example is Gypnema species. Didelphic prodelphic Female nematode with two ovaries present or directed towards anterior position of ulva. Examples are Melodogyne, Heterodera and Globodera species. Diadelphic, Opisthoid delphic, female nematode with two ovaries present or directed towards posterior position. Then such type of ovary are called as diadelphic, Opisthoid delphic. And amphidelphic, female nematode with two ovaries present with one directed towards anterior position while another towards posterior position of vulva is called as amphidelphic ovary. Examples are Talencoricus, Hoplolaemus and Helicotylenchus species. So, according to the position and number, these ovaries are classified into different names: monodelphic, single ovary; diadelphic, two ovaries; prodelphic, single ovary present anteriorly; opisthodelphic, single ovary posteriorly; diadelphic, prodelphic, two ovaries present anteriorly; diadelphic, opisthodelphic, two ovaries present posteriorly; amphidelphic, one ovary each on is at anterior side and posterior side. So let us see the figures. So here this is monodelphic. So here this is the ovary which is at anterior. Here is also ovary which is anterior. So here diadelphic, it is anterior position and it is posterior position. So we call it as amphidelphic. So in case of this prodelphic, so single ovary is present and it is directed toward anterior position. Opisthodelphic, single ovary is present and which is directed toward posterior position. Amphidelphic, two ovaries are present, one is directed towards anterior position while second one is at posterior position. So students, one may ask in your exam to draw out the figures of different types of ovary or give short note on types of ovaries which are present in nematode. So you can describe accordingly. One may ask to give examples. So here diadelphic, prodelphic ovary is present in Melodogyne, Heterodera, Globodera. Amphidelphic ovary is present in Talencoricus, Hoplolaemus and Helicolencus. So these example you must have to keep in mind. So in case of female reproductive system and male reproductive system, there is sexual dimorphism is present. So what is sexual dimorphism? It is a condition where the two sexes of same species, say example here as a nematode species, exhibit different characteristics beyond the differences in their sexual organs. So sexual organs are differentiated even though other features are also differentiated. So here some of the features are there. So in case of male nematode and female nematode, first one is the body of male is smaller. It is about 50 to 13 centimeter long and 3 to 5 millimeters wide. Body is larger. It is about 20 to 40 centimeter long and 6 to 8 millimeter wide. So here it was given in centimeter, but it is actually micrometer. So you consider likewise. Then tail end of the male curved ventrally, while in case of female tail end is straight. In case of male, anus and genital pore are common, that is cloacal aperture is present, while in case of female, anus and genital pore site, that is vulva, they are at different site. A pair of needle like penile setae is present in cloaca. So here in case of female there is no pineal setae. In case of male, these are pre-anal and post-anal papillae present. to help in copulation, where in case of female, such types of papillae are absent. So in case of nematode, there are different types of reproduction. First one is amphimictic reproduction, when the male as well as female nematodes reproduce sexually and gives rise to birth to offspring, then these are called as amphimictic type of reproduction. Second one is hermaphroditism. So it is more common in number of nematode. It is having functional male and female organs in the same individual. Then third one is parthenogenesis. So in this case, there is production of offspring occur without fertilization of the eggs. Example is molluscogyne and Tylenoculus semipenetrans. So dear friend, one may ask about sexual dimorphism. So you may write the definition and the features, or one may ask the difference between sexual dimorphism of male and female. So you may enlist. Also, one may ask about type of reproduction in the nematode. So you have to describe accordingly. So here in this figure, here it is hermaphrodite nematode in which there is presence of spermatic. So ovary is present, which produces eggs or ovum. This passes through this spermatheca. It means this nematode contains both male and female characteristics, whereas exomale, it contains only the male reproductive organs and do not contain any female reproductive organs. So here it is the difference. Dear students, now we will see nervous system of nematode. In nematode, central nervous system and a peripheral nervous system is present and which can be described. So what is central nervous system? So it is located centrally, but from that place there are number of nerves which are passes throughout the body part of nematode. First we will see the figures, then we will come to the theory part. So here this is the nematode nervous system, which is present as a nerve ring. So from this nerve ring, anterior or posterior side, either ventrally, dorsally or laterally, to both the side, the nerve rings are longitudinally present, and these are attached with by means of this horizontal commissures, and which gives rise to senses to whole body. So all this is about nervous system. That is why it is called as central nervous system. So next figure we can observe here. Here it is my mouth, esophagus or pharynx. So here on the isthmus there is presence of brain. It means it is nothing but a nerve ring from which this white color nerve is present. It is ventral nerve, it is dorsal nerve, it is lateral nerve, and it is present throughout the body. It may direct anterior or it may direct posterior, and that is why it is called as central nervous system. So now we will come to the theory parts. So it is also known as brain, consists of nerve ring associated with ganglion nerves. The nerve ring is circumesophageal commissure, and it is as like as belt, which may be broad or flat. So the nerve ring is present around the esophagus or around the pharynx. That is why it is called as circumesophageal nerve ring. It is present around the esophagus in majority of nematode. In Tylenchida, it encircles the isthmus, while in Dorylaemida group of nematode, it present around the narrow anterior part of the esophagus. The nerve ring is placed obliquely at most anterior dorsal side. Towards the anterior end of the nerve ring, 6 ganglia are present. So, upper position, 6 ganglia are present. 2 subdorsal. 2 subdorsal means at this side, 2 subdorsal ganglia. Second, 2 subventral, this side, and 2 lateral means this side ganglia. So, 6 ganglia are present. Towards the posterior side, nerve ring, nerves arises in the dorsal, lateral and ventral side of the body. Transverse commission connecting the nerves are also present in different regions of the body which bounds these vertical nerves and connect each other so that the senses come from central nervous system and it get. So, this is all about nervous system. Once again you can see this is obliquely present, this is ventral nerve, this is dorsal nerves, these are the lateral nerves and these are the commissures which are present horizontally. So, likewise here also ventral cord, dorsal cord, lateral cord and there are the commissures present and the nerves are also distributed over anterior, that is 6 nerves are present, 2 subventral, 2 subdorsal and 2 lateral position, we have already seen in the theory part. So, you have to describe in this way by drawing this figure or this figure, you can easily describe. So, when we will see anterior nervous system, so in anterior position, first of all we will see the mouth of the nematode. So, there are 6 lips, on which there is presence of amphids and there are some of the cephalic cheetae are present. So, at this position, if we see these are the 2 lateral position ganglia or nerve cells which are laterally present. This one and this one, these are the nerve rings which are present dorsally and these are present ventrally. So, subventral, subdorsal and lateral nerves are present in case of nematode at anterior position to that of esophagus. So, this is again the figure of anterior nervous system. So, here also you can see these are 2 subdorsal, these are 2 lateral and these are 2 ventral nerves. Then in case of posterior nervous system, this is ventral nerve cord, this is posterior nerve cord and this is lateral nerve cord. And so, these are the commissures, these are the horizontal commissures which bind to the nervous system. So, if you see these figures and observe the figures with their names, you can easily understand the nervous system of nematode. You can easily draw out figure easily and describe it easily. So, why this central nervous system, it is called as peripheral nervous system? Because it present in periphery of the nematode and it includes somatic nerve, cephalic papillary nerve, amphideal nerve, amphids, phasmids, derides, hemizonoid, hemizonian and other associated structures. Let us start with first, that is somatic nerve. So, the nerve which runs longitudinally in the hypodermis are called as somatic nerve. So, these are present in somatic tissues of the nematodes, that is why these are called as somatic nerve. First one is dorsal somatic nerve. It originates from the dorsal ganglia of the posterior side of the nerve ring, goes through the dorsal cord up to the anal region, where it bifurcate and join the lumbar ganglia. Laterodorsal nerve. It is paired structure, originate from the nerve ring and extend toward the position side in the submedian position. They also innervate the muscular layer. Lateroventral nerve. It originates from the nerve ring and extend posterior or submedian position. Ventral nerve. It is the part of central nervous system. Lateral nerve. It is an anal, present in anal area and having lumbar ganglia on each side. Dorsolateral nerve. These are the pair nerve and joins the ventrolateral nerve in anal region. So, dear student, if we observe the words or meaning of each and every thing here, you can easily understand these all nerves. So, suppose dorsal somatic nerve, what does it mean? It present dorsally, backside, these are present, and below hypodermis or in the hypodermis, these are present. So, dorsal somatic nerve. Second, laterodorsal somatic nerve means this side, laterodorsal. Lateroventral nerve means this side it may present. Ventral nerve means this side. Lateral nerve means this side. Dorsolateral nerve means this side. So, accordingly, you keep in mind all the nerve system or the nerves and explain. Then second types of nerves are cephalic papillary nerve. These nerves goes through the body cavity. These are nerve fibers arising from cephalic papillary ganglia from the cephalic nerve near the lips. So, this is the cephalic region. So, these are called, these all the nerves are called as cephalic nerve. Second one is amphedial nerve. The nerves which are goes to the amphids, these are called as amphedial nerve. So, those nerves which are goes towards papilla, these are called as cephalic papillary nerve, while those nerves which are ends in the amphids, then these are called as amphedial nerve. So, what is amphids? Amphids are the paired laterally, paired lateral sensory organs, probably act as a chemoreceptors, situated in cephalic region, situated in cephalic region of the nematode. The amphid aperture exhibits various shapes. This may be oar shape, circular, hooked shape, stirrup shape or spiral shape. They may be sexual dimorphism present in case of amphids, as these are generally large in case of female than that of, they are generally larger in male in case of, than that of females, or may be more complex in males. So, phasmids. Phasmids are the paired lateral sense organs, usually one on each side of the tail at lateral pits. The phasmids open to the exterior through a minor pore. Internally, they possess a canal or pouch containing sensory receptor, which are supplied by lateral caudal nerve. In a few nematode species, they may enlarged and known as scutella. So, this is all about phasmids and amphids. Then, derates, paired papillae, these are nothing but the paired papillae, which are situated in the mid region of esophagus, opposite to the excretory pore. So, here excretory pore, it is opposite to that of excretory pore, and it acts as a sensory structure, but do not have an opening outside. They are also called as cervical papillae. They function as mechanoreceptor. Then, hemi zonid and hemizonian. So the hemizonid, it is just like a belt or girdle like. It is highly refractive biconvex structure forming semicircle in the ventral side of the body and ending at the lateral fields, located either anterior or posterior to the excretory pore. It is either present at this position or it may be present anterior position and situated between the cuticle and the hypodermis. So hemizonian are just like a hemizonid, but these are small nerve commissure than that of hemizonid, which is structurally identical to the hemizonid and situated posterior to the hemizonid. So this is hemizonid and hemizonian. This is derides. So now we will see the cephalids. Like hemizonid and hemizonians, cephalids are also highly refractive band like structures situated in the cuticle dorsally and ventrally, but they form a complete ring or round the body anteriorly just behind the cephalic region. So at this position they are present. Generally the lateral epidermal cord originate at a level of posterior cephalids. Then the caudalids, it is a small nerve commissure which is situated in the caudal region, slightly posterior to the anus. So it is present posterior to that of anus and linking the preanal ganglia to the lumbar ganglia. So here it is not given there, but these cephalids are present over here while these caudalids are present over here. So these are all the sensory structures. So in your exam, one may ask about cephalids, caudalids, derides, hemizonid, hemizonian, amphid, phasmids, etc. So you can draw out the figure. You have to mention the position of these cephalids, caudalids, phasmids in the figure and state the functions of each and every sensory structure which are present in the nematode. So dear friend, this is one figure. In my last lecture, I have described general morphology of nematode, and while searching on internet, I got this figure in which each and every thing is clearly mentioned. So you can draw out this figure when anyone asks in your exam to draw out and well label the figure. So this is the male and this is the female nematode. So dear students, one may ask the questions on the reproductive system as well as central nervous system. There are number of questions may be asked in the exams on the objective. So you must have to go through this lecture video so that you can get clear cut idea. If once again I request you to comment if there is any mistake or if you are having any suggestion, you clearly mention it so that I will incorporate it in next lectures. Thank you. Thank you so much.